The title of my paper is Can Lay People Be Empowered to Face the Challenges of COVID-19? Lessons Learned from a Community Intervention. And I'm Nadipa Ratnaikar. COVID-19 is spreading across the globe, and everyone should play a role to prevent the transmission, and even lay communities need to contribute. And this process should be owned by the lay communities, and lay communities should be the active partners in this process of preventing COVID-19 transmission. The aim of the present study was to explore whether lay people can be empowered to face the challenges of COVID-19. In 156 abstract, I explained the process, and in brief, this process was led by a group of 4 trained lay community members, and they were trained on health promotion approach from the Department of Health Promotion in Rajarat University. And they are the members in our health promotion advocacy network as well. It was for the first time that a government university allowed lay people to get a training on health promotion, and it was from the Rajarat University. And in this study, at the end of the 5 months, data were collected by using 3 methods. The first one was the lead mothers were maintaining reflective diaries throughout the process. The second one was the lead mothers collected data from different tools that they created, like calendars to assess the level of risk and to measure the adherence to proper safety precautions. And third one, at the end of the 5 months, telephone interviews were conducted with the lead mothers. And all the data collected by using these means were analyzed thematically. In the pictures, you can see how lead mothers have analyzed the data collected from the tools by using different graphs and all. And these results were sent to the principal investigator monthly. In results, 3 key themes were emerged. The first one was actions to prevent the transmission, and under that, the villagers started to follow proper safety precautions, and people in Anuradhapura identified a common place in their village for a community quarantine center. Its purpose was to quarantine any suspected villager in the future. And mothers identified that tobacco smoking elevates the risk of getting the disease, and they started to take actions to reduce the tobacco smoking and alcohol consumption among villagers. The second key theme emerged was care and support. Villagers started to care about each other and to support each other. For example, people in Monaragala started to grow vegetables along the roadsides, and they allowed needy people to get the vegetables without making any payment, and they paid an attention on elders and people with non-communicable diseases as well. The third theme emerged was overcoming any fear, anxiety, and stigma. Villagers reported that they felt more confident and happier about handling potential risks and challenges because they were better informed with the intervention. These outcomes were widely published in both printed and electronic media, and through that, we were able to spread this process to other districts of Sri Lanka as well. In conclusion, yes, lay people can be empowered to deal with the challenges of COVID-19, and they could work out mutual safety and supportive measures while protecting themselves and the others. And they became the active agents in handling COVID-related situations in their communities. At the end, I would like to grateful all the 4 lead mothers for the co-authors of our study as well. Thank you very much.